And now we move on to a panel of product and tech chiefs, you know, and we want to find out what new thinking they've had to adopt, what new tech they are working on, and how they are addressing the talent headache. Please welcome David Liu from Klook. We have Chan Chi Chong from GlobalTix. We have Richard Kwa from Wego. And we have Khang Nguyen Trieu from Accor. Hi, guys. How are you?
Hey, hello.
Hey, how's it going?
Fantastic.
Hello, everyone.
Very good. Okay, good. You are the techies, and we are putting you in the spotlight this time. What we're going to do is we're going to divide the conversation into three parts, right? And this is going to be a very speedy road trip, guys. Are you ready? Okay. The first one is about thinking, right? So the first question is, I'm going to address it to CC and Khang. One old thinking from my perspective was, tech is tech, marketing is marketing. What attempt have you made personally to learn about marketing? CC, we start with you.
Okay, well, as a founder and a salesman of a company, I think it has been easier for me to understand marketing. And marketing is damn important. And perception is everything. I give a quick example, right? GlobalTix, we have been pitching that we are channel manager. So we tell people that the tech people always say that you can do it, the product you can take and you can distribute. But there is nowhere inside my system that says the tech channel manager. And I got clients calling us, hey, you like, where's the channel manager you talk about, right? So this is the failure when tech is tech. Tech say, yeah, it's done, can be done. But marketing, just fail it.
Okay. Khang, we go to you. You are the group chief technology architect. So, you know, what attempt have you made personally to learn more about marketing?
Yeah, personally. So I say because I joined Accor only one year and a half ago. So pretty new to the hospitality. And what I've been doing is more spending time on virtual coffee with colleagues from non-IT functions to understand that job. And then we also have what we call a learning and development hub, which is called Accor Academy, where there are sessions done by the different teams to hotel staff, everything. And so I often join this training online. And the latest one was about typically the notion of staycation in different countries and which kind of targets you have depending on the countries. How do you segment the different targets depending on the countries?
So to understand consumer trends. So David and Richard, the next question is to you. One old thinking for me was tech people just want to be left alone to develop and don't want to speak to people, especially customers. What have you done to change that perception or reality? David, we go to you.
Well, I think this is more about ownership, right? What we've been doing is trying to hold the team together and then trying to get them hold accountable for what they're building. And naturally, when the whole team, that includes the technical person and everyone else, when you are truly sort of holding that ownership, you will naturally want to understand your customers and talk to them, right? Otherwise, what are you building for? So I think that's more about ownership, yeah.
Right, okay. Richard?
I think on top of that, I'm just gonna say, like, I'm a natural introvert, so it was really hard to get myself to say, you know what, I'm gonna talk to customers. It took me a long time. So I think what we're doing here in Wego is that we're making sure that in some ways we're pleasantly forcing everyone to live and breathe UX research. So monthly we do showcases. We've started that. We're showing what we're learning when we talk to customers, when we're looking at the numbers to back up the qualitative results. And then I think more importantly is that we're highlighting the mistakes that we've done either throughout the process or what we've done before. And then I think what I've noticed is that we're kind of bringing everyone in the company through the process of say, actually, it is important. So my hope there,
right, so,
internally, you know, it'll get people to drive rather than me dragging people around.
Yeah, it seems to me like what John said earlier in the Agoda session was one old thinking was a lot of people, you know, a lot of companies thought that they could go it alone. But, you know, this crisis just demands that everybody must get together, you know, whether it's outside the companies or within the companies. So let's move on to the subject of tech. OK, and if you can share briefly, what are you currently working on that's challenging you and worth us knowing about? So let's start with you, CC.
To me, I think the thing that changed a lot of in the last 5 years or in the last 10 years is messaging. So unlike John, I still think that messaging is chatbot is still going to be very critical. So what we've been working on is not just a simple chatbot, but how can a chatbot transact? For example, if you ask, where's my driver? And I'll respond to you the Google map of the driver, right? So I still think that there's a lot of room to grow in chatbot, and there's something that I wish to really crack it.
Okay. Richard?
Ooh, that's a... which one?
Come on.
So I think the biggest one would be really revamping what we are currently doing as a meta search. I think, you know, we pass on our users to our partners, but I think there's been a lot of things, especially during COVID, that we really need to be very, very laser focused on. We're getting a lot of feedback from customers on what they want and what they don't want. So I think right now, I think the adage of, you know, focus is about saying no. It's been really important. So an example there would be for customer support. So right now, you know, we're in our app, you know, we're bombarding customers with, okay, well, you can find stuff here and there, but we didn't really make it easy for them. But once they talk to us, they get the support that they need. And then suddenly we get all these five stars. So we really have to surface that. And that's what we're working on right now.
Okay, so common theme of making customer support easy. David, what about you?
Yeah, our challenge is because Klook is operating on multiple markets and then different users, because of COVID, we're sort of forced to do domestic. And then each of these domestic markets are in very different stages of the COVID. So what we need to do is to try to build a system that is very reusable, flexible, and agile. While at the same time, because the situation has changed very, very rapidly, one market can be in lockdown this year, this weekend and next week, it suddenly opens up, right? So that flexibility, reusable, agile system that is built per market, per stage, and it's fully controllable by each of the local markets. That's something we're working on. It's quite challenging, but I hope once we do that, we'll be very, very competitive.
Wow, that's an amazing platform, like a template for you know, going from market to market, localized. What about you, Khang?
On our side, I say we have three big topics. One, which is for the hotel owners, we are really working very hard to build what we call the hotel in the cloud, meaning how do we bring all the systems. Today we talk about PMS, POS, etc. Today, which are mostly on-premise in hotels and quite heavy, I would say, for the hotel owners to manage and from a cost perspective. And we are working very hard to push everything on the cloud and having a consolidated offering where everything will be there. For the guests, it will be very much about building Accor as a platform around a lot of API to multiply the touch point, to allow a lot of integration of partners into our systems for more offerings for the guests. And the third big topic, I think, is related to talent. It's for our people. We are rethinking the ways of working within the tech teams. A lot of inspiration from leading companies like GitLab, which are completely remote and still able to build amazing products. And we are looking at how we can get inspiration so that we offer also this kind of environment for our teams.
Right. So it sounds like all of you are really busy, but Khang is working on three big projects, guys. Three big projects. So let's talk about, you know, when I asked John about what did you build recently, you know, like in the last 12 to 24 months that turned out to be useless. Pick one. I'm sure there are lots to pick from, but pick one. CC, we start with you.
Just before COVID, I built a travel agent frontline system where they can set the price. This is to help them for their road shows and their events. No? So nobody's using it.
Okay, good. Maybe you can revive it just as John has revived his digital payments. Okay, let's go to Richard.
So we built some partnership. We built destination pages with our partners pre-COVID, and then clearly when COVID hit, we can't really launch it because no one's traveling. So that's a bit useless.
Okay.
But with that the learning there was that we realized that actually, you know, when we weren't talking internally. So the good news is that we realized that and we say, you know what, let's tweak the process and make sure from product, commercial, marketing, everyone just needs to talk before we do something. So, you know, it's not all that bad.
That's good. All right, David.
Yeah, we did build a point-to-point train ticketing booking system back before COVID. We were hoping that this would help the travelers to book just train tickets anywhere. But since COVID has hit, the only market we could really test that out is in China, which then got locked down as well. So I wouldn't say that's useless. It's just it's not useful yet because we don't have the chance to even try it out.
Yeah, but it can be rolled out when it's ready. Okay, so Khang, about you?
Let's hope so.
So on my side, it was because it was before Accor actually, because I joined too recently, but it was building a tracking tool for corporate travelers in the former company I was with. And it was not that it was useless, but it was very painful because there were teams split between product between US, London, development in Singapore, Philippines, testing in India. And everybody was thinking that we were actually doing agile, but it was a very good learning to say that when you are not really agile yet, don't try to do like the big ones, but be more humble to start with.
Okay, I'm gonna go to polling now. If we can pull out the first poll, because we wanna talk about consumer tech, right? And actually we have a question that basically talked about what consumers are looking for. So the question in the polling is, of these four choices, which consumer tech do you think will win travelers over? Is it A, translation tools? Is it B, chat? Is it C, suggestions backed by AIs? Is it D, digital payments? Can each of you answer? If it's not one of the four, what's the fifth? Very quickly, Cece.
Chat. I'm a strong believer chat. In chat.
Okay. Mm. Okay. Richard.
Definitely chat. It's advanced so much. And right now, people really need that connection. So definitely chat.
Okay, David?
Suggestion by AI.
Suggestions by AI. Okay, Khang?
Yeah.
A consumer tool.
Digital payments.
Digital payments. Okay. Now, I will check on the poll later when I get the results from the poll. So now I want to ask you either or questions, right? Just pick one. In-house or outsource? Cece?
Outsource.
Okay, Richard?
In-house.
Okay, David?
Well, can I take in-house, but plus we want to do partnership with other sort of developers?
Okay, you get that choice, okay?
Yeah, then I pick in-house and partnership.
Okay, cool. Khang? In-house or outsource?
Yeah, in-house as much as possible.
Okay, so basically from the poll, we have people picking suggestions backed by AIs and digital payments, kind of neck and neck. Okay, now it is said that a good product must satisfy A, customer depth, B, technology depth, C, commercial depth. Which is most important to you? Pick one. I know you're going to say all are important, but you got to pick one. Cece.
Commercial.
Okay, Richard.
Definitely customer. I know it's cheesy, but customers will pay the bills and pay for the technology. So, you know, customer trumps them all.
Okay, David.
Same here. I think customer is ultimately what we're trying to serve. And then once that is done, I think the commercial and technical part are just ways to do it, sustainability and then maybe on a large scale.
Okay. Khang, are you going to choose technology depth?
No, agree with the customer because I think it puts the technology and commercial.
Okay, so we have a question from the audience, it related to the poll where, you know, what are some of the new things that they are looking for? Are there any clear trends in what consumers are looking for? Any surprises? So CC, can we go to you?
For travel, I think information is important as well, right? I mean, it has Amadeus have also shown that that's the number one. So really, you all the friends whom is flying has been texting nonstop to say, can I come back to Singapore? What is the latest? Is it a yes or no? And things like that. So I think information is going to be critical in the next 1-2 years.
Okay. Richard, anything surprising?
Nothing surprising. The main ones I have to say is payments and information. Payments, pretty straightforward. If you're desperate to go home or fly somewhere, you need accessibility to be able to pay for that quarantine flight. The information, spot on. There's just so much out there. It's already a bit too much. So us, internally, we are really focusing and making sure that our data quality is really good for our customers.
Okay. All right. David, anything that stands out?
Yeah, not surprising, but you'll be amazed to see how customers are now searching for domestic things to do, because that's basically what they only can. So that's what we're keeping focusing on as well.
So you mean customers are not only searching for domestic, they're actually searching beyond domestic as well?
No, I think they're mainly searching for things to do that they didn't used to do domestically. So any of the small shows or anything that can get them out of the house, they're searching for that.
Okay. All right. That's interesting. Khang, what about you? What are you seeing among your guests?
Yeah, no, so I think indeed the topic of payment is crucial, because I think now people are getting used to apps like Revolut and having be able not to worry about having a different kind of currencies when they travel anymore. One thing that we really see also is all the need around contactless, obviously, because it's part of the new world where touching things can be risky. And so contactless is also, I think, a trend which is very high.
Right. Okay. So let's talk about one transformation technology that you've not explored yet, but you're keen to play with or keen to learn. Let's start with David this time.
Well, I think AR is definitely something we are keen on looking into. Imagine you're, you know, in another city traveling, or in your own city, then with the AR help, what you can get from your glasses or something else while you are doing the activities you used to do, and you can see more, and basically we can tell the users more information. So that we haven't been looking into, but I think it will be very exciting.
Right. Richard?
Definitely VR, because I want to shut everything out and just be in the zone. It's also been a bit of a childhood thing for me, where, you know, like the old school VR headsets, you go to the arcade, you go to play around. So that would be amazing if we could get somehow. It still hasn't, for so many years, it still hasn't kicked off. But I think I can see so many use cases, especially for travel. But yeah, would love
to. And education as well. So Khang, what's one transformation technology that you've not explored yet?
Yeah, for me, I think it has to do with climate change, and the thing that for our hotels, I think that the topic of IoT and clean tech technologies to reach zero net emission level, which I believe one is super critical for the topic of climate change. But I think that people also start to be more and more aware of that topic, and that guests would be looking for this kind of requirement in the next 10 years, probably.
Okay, CC, last but not least.
Yeah, I'm going to say a very boring stuff. I think low code, no code. I'm really keen to study it, because I think with low code, no code, it means that new products can be launched in the quickest time. So I think that will change a lot in the next few years. So that's something I'm keen to learn.
Yeah, you're very practical. Okay, so one thing that tech cannot solve. CC.
Imagination. I think all product owners need to have imagination and the vision to say what products they want to have. Tech can't solve that.
Okay, Richard.
Reading the tea leaves. You know, all these cross-cultural interactions. I don't think that's a lot of data points to process. I really don't think that tech can solve that anytime soon.
Okay, David.
It's the human touch, you know, with all the technical parts, humans are still, you know, what you interact with, especially when you travel.
Okay. Khang,
I would say empathy. I think that's something that is deeply needed more and more in our world, and that's something that tech cannot achieve.
Okay. One tech that you don't believe in, Sisi?
Coins, crypto coins, blockchain coins.
Okay. Richard?
This is hard, working in tech. I'd say, you know, Ice Alice, that robot thing in Sentosa that serves ice cream? That doesn't make sense, because if there's a person beside it looking after the robot, what's the point? So, just saying. I love tech, so.
Okay, you'd rather buy ice cream from a human than a robot. Okay, David.
Well, I can't come up with something I don't believe. I think that there are a lot of things I don't know yet, because I haven't sort of invested into the technical parts.
So. Okay, all right. We'll let you get away with that, David. Khang.
Well, thanks.
I don't know if I can go like David, because I think I believe in all tech, but just when it is used in a meaningful way.
Exactly. Okay, so now we move on to talent, right? You know, so we're going to ask the audience for polling. And the poll is, talent is now my biggest headache because A, travel is too hard right now. B, other sectors are way more exciting. C, travel cannot pay as much as gaming or logistics, etc. And D, I joined travel to travel, but now I can't. So pick one answer that suits you. Talent is your biggest headache because? CC.
D, I think once the techie can travel, they will fall in love with travel. So when you can't travel, you can't feel the excitement of travel.
Exactly. Okay, Richard.
I think I joined travel to travel. So like it just doesn't make sense. Why would you be in this industry if you can't do it? So yeah.
That's why you have to build those virtual reality tours, Richard. Okay, exactly. David.
I think travel is too hard now, but A and D is essentially the same now. So travel is too hard now. Yeah.
Okay. All right, Khang.
Yeah, for me, D as well. I think that's a kind of a blocker for people.
Okay, so one idea, therefore, on how travel as an industry can compete for tech talent against other verticals. So let's go with Richard.
I think we really have to be great mentors for the next generation and for your teams. Because no matter how much you get paid, I'm sure all of us have been there before, whereby you don't have mentors and you just stagnate in your career. You don't learn
anything. Yeah. I mean, it's like what John said, right? Like if you're A leaders, then you attract A team members and you get to work on A projects. So anybody has a different answer on how we can attract, compete for tech talent? Khang?
I would say that actually travel is still an attractive industry if you look at it. If you would give the choice maybe for someone to work in the bank or in a travel company, I think really in terms of industry, in travel is still very much attractive. I think the big challenge today is more that people joining travel could say, okay, but am I going to be fired in 6 months, 1 year because the company is not doing well? And I think that's a legitimate concern. And for that, I would say that looking at it from travel outside, hiring in travel, say that what we must be able to offer to people joining us is to say that indeed they are still going to progress and to upskill whatever the situation is, meaning that their employability will not suffer from working in travel, but on the contrary, they will continue to build amazing things.
All right. Okay, let's go to another. Let's go to another poll, okay? Of these five tech personalities, who do you most admire? A, Elon Musk, Tesla. B, Zhang Yiming, TikTok. C, Fusajiro Yamauchi, who founded Nintendo in 1889. Imagine that Nintendo is still like, you know, winning all the top games, right? D, Tan Hui Ling from Grab. E, Ma Hua Teng from Tencent. Okay, pick one. If you you know, who do you most admire? Let's go to David.
Yamauchi.
Okay, interesting. Richard.
Oh, Yamauchi. Just the other day I bought the Lego Mario. So like, hell yeah.
Yeah. I mean, talk about longevity, right? You know, I mean, this, you know, his brand has really lasted over the centuries, actually. So, CC.
Tencent. Okay. I think it's one of the first super app, and he did his work quietly without big fanfare.
Okay. All right. Khang, who do you pick?
Tan Hui Ling. I think it is great to see women in leadership positions in tech companies.
Okay, so now I'm gonna go rapid fire and you just do thumbs up or thumbs down, okay? No words, okay? Chatbot. Okay, all thumbs up. Blockchain. Oh, okay, CC not the decisive enough. Crypto coins. Okay, all thumbs down. Buy now, pay later. Buy now, pay later.
Right.
Okay, go up. Oh, Khang says no. Khang goes down. Okay. AI. Up. Okay. Fintech. Up. All up. Okay. Gamification. Up. CC. Horizontal, all up. Okay, CC horizontal. Okay, so final word from you guys, right? You know, final word. If money and talent were not an object, what would you want to build right now in travel? CC.
Oh, I'm going to be boring again. Connectivity. I want to have 1,000 developers to connect to 1,000 systems.
Okay, practical. Richard.
Ooh, a GDS gateway, that would be cool. Because there are payment gateways, buy now, pay later gateways. There's like gateway for gateway. So, you know, yeah.
Okay, cool. David.
I will build an AI that will help the customers to as a personal assistant for their trip planning.
Okay. And Khang, last word to you.
I would build his net zero emission hotels with augmented hospitality for both local and travelers.
Fantastic. Well, thank you so much to our product chiefs. You guys have been amazing and inspiring. David, CC, Khang, and Richard, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Thank you
very much. Yeah. All right. Bye. So-